السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is lecture 2 and it will be about tractors. Before we going to talk about tractors, there are many forms of energy used for agriculture or at the agriculture sector. First of all, after discovering the agriculture, the human being used his human power or human energy in agriculture, and we can see this all over the drawing over the temple of pharaohs, as we will see in the next page. Then he used the animal energy or the animal power, and to make the effort in the agriculture sector is less, or to make it not so hard work, to make it easier for him, he used the mechanical energy after the invention of the internal combustion engine and the tractor. Nowadays we use electrical energy or electrical power in the agriculture sector also, and renewable energy such as biogas, biomass, solar energy, and so on. As we mentioned before, we used the human power and the animal power in the agriculture sector. As we can see here, the human being, and here, and of course the human power in agriculture sector or agricultural process. But you can ask yourself, do we still use the human power in this work? And the answer would be yes, we still do that. As we can see here, the human being is still working or using his own power or his own energy to do work. The average man can work or give power about 0.1 horsepower HP for horsepower. The horsepower is equal or about the horsepower equal 750 watt. And as we mentioned before, the horsepower is power unit like watt and kilowatt. The woman can develop half of this power, about 0.05. But nowadays, the availability of the human power for farm operations is decreasing. Also, the animal power is still used in agriculture work in Egypt till nowadays. The animal can work or can pull a weight about 1/10 of his body weight or of its body weight. Of course, there is advantage and disadvantage for the animal work. Animal work can do tractive work more than stationary work. We will talk about those type of work in the next section. So the animal can do the tractive work, but it can't do stationary work in a good way or in high efficiency. Also, if we don't use the animal after doing what we want, we won't just store the animal till we need it again. The tractor or the engine, we can store the tractor or engine between work to another work. This may be months, 2 months, year, whatever, but we can't do that with animal. Animal need care, need food, need water, need health care, even if I am not using it in the agriculture work. So the animal is not efficient. The animal is affected by the weather, if it's so hot, if it's raining, his efficiency or his its productivity will decrease. Also require full care even when we don't use it. Very slow in doing work, but it still have some advantages, like it may be cheaper, and it's also supplies manure or fertilizer we can use in the agriculture system. As we mentioned before, we have two kind of farm work: attractive work and stationary work. Attractive work, it's this kind of work we do while the machine or the tractor is moving. So if the work done while the tractor moving from place to another place, this is attractive work, such as seed bedding, seed bed preparation, cultivation, harvesting, transportation, and so on. Stationary work is this kind of work done while the tractor stay or still at the same place, so the tractor is not moving. We mostly use the RPM, revolution per minute, or the and this kind of work, like silage cutting, feed grinding, lifting, irrigation water, and so on. So as we mentioned before, the animal can easily do the tractive work while it's hard and not efficient to do stationary work. As we mentioned before, the human power availability is decreasing, and the animal power is not efficient, not giving us high productivity, so we used mechanization. So mechanization objectives are increasing the productivity. Even for bare agricultural worker, so instead of human being use his power to do the work himself, he can do he can serve one faddan per week, for example. Now I'll give this human being or the same farmer a tractor. He will drive the tractor, and now his productivity is about 3 faddan per day. So we are increasing the productivity even per worker. Also, this will change the character of farm work. We said it's hard. So when we use the tractor, it will be less harder or more easier and more attractive to the worker. Also, to improve the quality of operation or field operation, providing better soil environment, seed germination, and plant growth. that's because the tractor can give or blow more than human being with as we said more productivity and more quality. Using mechanical power in agriculture sector is important, and it's available through tractors and internal combustion engine. In this lecture, we will talk about the tractor, and later we will talk about the internal combustion engine. So the advantage of using mechanical power, it's the mechanical power advantage is the disadvantage of the animal power and vice versa. So it's more efficient, it's not affected by weather, it can do both type of work, the tractive work easily and also the stationary work. It's cheaper form of power and require less space. Someone will ask about how the tractor can require less space than a donkey or a horse. It's not we are not comparing a horse with a tractor. No, if we have a tractor and this tractor have a power about 200 horsepower, now we can compare this tractor 200 horsepower with a real 200 horsepower. In this case, the tractor will require less space and it will be cheaper for horsepower unit or for power unit. It's a disadvantage, of course. It will be it will cost, so we need the initial costs. The fuel will cost us, and repair, maintenance, and so on. In this table, it's a comparison between tractor and animal power, and as we mentioned before, the stationary work, the animal is have a limit use for this work, but the tractor can do it easily. The transportation, we can use animal in transportation, but for short and medium distance. But of course, a tractor we can use in medium and long distance. As we said before, the cost of operation, bare horsepower, the tractor will be cheaper. The space, as we said before, bare horsepower, the tractor will require less space. Idleness. Idleness is when we don't use the animal or when we don't use the tractor. If we don't use the tractor, it won't consume any fuel, lubricant, while not used. Instead of the animal will require food, water, health care, and so on. But it will, on the other hand, provide us with manure for agriculture. The output, the tractor will give us high and suitable power for operations, while the animal power is low. And as we said, the animal can tract or can pull around 1/10 of his or of its own weight. This is the end of part one. Till we meet in part two. Thanks for listening.